you have already done yesterday with exercise 1.3. Now we'll start with the rules of division of integers. Let's see what are the rules we have to follow while doing the division of integers. Here suppose quality number 12 is divided by quality integer 3, then the answer is 4. If negative integer 12 is divided by negative integer, then also the answer is 4. Means if you are having two integers of same sign, both the integers are of same sign, then the quotient is positive. Means if you are having integers with same sign, integers with same sign, either both are positive or both are negative, then the quotient is positive. In both the cases, the quotient will be in positive. Now, if one term or one integer is negative and negative integer is divided by positive integer, then the answer will be negative. Either 12 is divided by positive integer is divided by one negative integer, then also the answer will be negative. By this we can conclude that integers with different sign, when they are divided, then the quotient is negative. Okay class? Now, properties of division of integers. First one is closure property, as you are already aware of it. But in division, it is not closed. It is not closed under division C. Why it is not closed under division C? If 12 is divided by 3, then the answer is 4. But if we divide 15 divided by 7, then you will get an integer? No, it will be 15 upon 7 only. This is an integer and this is not an integer. It's a fraction, or you can say it's a rational number. So that's why it is not closed under division. We are not getting every time the answer as a integer. Now, second one is, it is not commutative, because you know, like if you do 15 divided by 3 is equal to how much? 5. But 3 divided by 15 will be equal to how much? 1 upon 15. That will be equal to 1 upon 5. So 5 is not equal to 1 upon 5, right? So they are not commutative. Means 15 divided by 3 is not equal to 3 divided by 15. Now next comes the division by 0 is meaningless, because if you divide suppose 11 divided by 0, then it is not defined. So division by 0 is of no use. Okay, now we have already done with all the properties of division. Now exercise 1.4. Very first question you are having is evaluate the following. Minus 36 divided by minus 9. Both the terms are negative, or we can say both the integers are negative. So you know, when both the integers are of same sign, then the answer is coming in positive. Or we can say the quotient is in positive. Means minus 36 divided by minus 9 will give you answer in positive, and normal number will divide 36 divided by 9. That is 4. Again here, 150 divided by minus 1, minus 25 means you have to solve how you divide, because one is negative and one is positive and one is negative, the answer will come in negative. 150 divided by minus 25, that is minus sign is in front, and 150 will be divided by directly by 25, that is minus 6 will be your answer. Now next question is question number 2. Evaluate the following. 13 divided by within the bracket minus 2 plus 1. You know that within the bracket it is there. First we have to solve the within the bracket 1 by Bodmer's rule. So the solution will be 13 divided by minus 2 plus 1 will give you 13 is outside. So first we will solve within the bracket minus 2 plus 1. 1 is negative, 1 is positive, and we have to add. Means what is the answer? Minus 1. Now, this is 13. 13 divided by minus 1 will give you what? Minus of 13 divided by 1. That is only 13. So, minus 13 will be your answer. Next question is, minus 6 plus 5 within the bracket divided by minus 2 plus 1 within the bracket. Means, how you will solve? First, you will solve both the brackets. Minus 6 plus 5 divided by minus 2 plus 1. So, minus 6 plus 5 will give you how much? Minus 1. Divided by again, minus 2 plus 1 will give you again minus 1. Both are negative, and negative divided by negative will give you answer in positive. And 1 divided by 1 is what? 1 only. So, answer is plus 1, that is positive 1. Now, next question is 3. Third question, verify that A divided by B within the bracket is divided by C is not equal to A divided by within bracket B divided by C. Now see, just we have to put the value and we have to show LHS and RHS. Different are there and we have to find the value for both. What is LHS here? LHS is A divided by B divided by C. Put the value. What is A? Minus 225 divided by what is B? 15 divided by what is C? Minus 3. So 15 but 225 divided by 15 will give you minus 15 divided by minus 3. Now negative negative is divided and you get the answer in positive. What will be the answer? 5. Plus 5. Now see the RHS. What is RHS here? A divided by B divided by C. This is your RHS. Again put the value. What is A? Minus 225 divided by. Within the bracket 15 divided by minus 3. Again we will solve first the within the bracket. 15 divided by minus 3 will give you 5 with minus sign. Now this is also negative, this is also negative, and we have to divide. But 225 divided by 5 will give you 5 4 the 20 and 5 5 the 25 with positive sign. So you can see, although we got both the sides as positive sign, but the final answer is not equal. So LHS is not equal to RHS, and this only we have to do the verification. They are not equal. Hence verify. Next question is question number 6. In a competition, 3 marks are given for every correct answer. Means plus 3 marks are given for every correct answer and minus 2 marks are given for every incorrect answer. Means if the answer is wrong, then minus 2 marks has been given. And no marks for not attempting any questions. Means if you have not attempted, so no marks means 0 marks is there. Now first question is, Sachin scored 24 marks. He has got 24 marks. If he got 14 correct answers, he has done 14 questions correctly. How many questions has he attempted incorrectly? How many questions he has done wrong means we have to find. Now see, marks obtained for 14 correct answer will be equal to how much? Every correct question is given. We are getting 3 marks. So 14 questions he has done correctly. So 14 into 3 means he has got 42 marks for correct answer. But his score is, Sachin's score is how much? Is only 24. Right? So marks obtained for incorrect answer as he has scored total this much and correct answer marks for this much, so how you get the incorrect one? Marks obtained for incorrect answer will be equal to 24 minus 42. means when you subtract, you will get 2, no sorry, you will get 12 minus 4 is 8 and 1 with minus 9. Minus 18 you will get the scoring for the incorrect answer. Now, marks for 1 incorrect answer. Is equal to how much? Minus 2, because minus 2 marks I will get for incorrect answer. So number of what question is asking for? How many questions he has attempted wrongly? So questions attempted wrongly will be equal to how much? Minus 18 divided by minus 2. Both are negative. So, what answer you get? 9 means he has attempted 9 questions incorrectly. His second part is, Nalini scores minus 7 marks in this competition. Though, she has got 9 correct answers. How many questions she has attempted incorrectly? Same here. Marks obtained, she has done 9 correct answers, so marks obtained for 9 correct answers will be equal to 9 into 3, that is 27, and her score is, Nalini's score is equal to minus 7. So marks obtained for incorrect answers is equal to how much? Minus 7 minus 27. That is 34. With minus sign, right? And marks for 1 incorrect answer is equal to minus 2. So, number of questions he has attempted incorrectly means number of questions attempted incorrectly will be equal to how much? Minus 34 divided by minus 2. That is equal to 17. The 17 questions she has attempted wrongly. Now we have done with maximum questions of exercise 1.4. The rest question you will do as a homework assignment. Thank you.